So we here was Lisa Lefebvre, right? I got your name right. Cool. And you are you work at the museum
of Texas.
And you work with Connie Groenewegen on
this
collection.
She's one of our clients, and she did all the knitwear collection that she presented today is made at the Textile Museum. So I get to see the whole process from when she comes to us with the sketches, and then to see the final pieces on the model. So it's really nice.
So how were you involved in this? What
actually,
is your job?
At the Textile Museum, my colleague did all the knitwear for her for the season. So, but I get involved because she's sitting across from my desk, so I see all the... And also I do the yarn library, so I advise her on yarn choices and technical questions, how to get the ideas she has in her head translated to textiles.
So how long does it take for a designer, you know, to develop their fabrics?
Oh,
normally?
I think she's been working with us for months. So, and also she did the previous collections as well, so she has a really good technical knowledge of knitwear. She's really preparing our files herself to bring to us. But it can take weeks to get one piece really perfect with a good yarn and the right motif.
Just for a little piece.
Well, you make first a sample, but to make a whole garment that fits properly, then it's another step. So
okay, so that takes the most time, I guess.
Yeah, I think so. And also because she likes to work with luxury yarn, so silk that breaks into the machine.
It's hard to make.
Yeah.
Okay, and can you tell me a bit more about your own work? Because I was fascinated by a flat jewelry thing back a few years ago.
Well, I'm still working on this, and little laser cut modules as well, as you know. And I'm working on lots of... Well, maybe you can zoom on my shoes, because I'm working on a project that's made of facets like this.
Can you maybe put your shoe on that in the flowers in the light or something of it?
There's grass on it, so it fits better.
Oh, wow. So it's like a crystal,
it's made of facets, and I have a little picture for you.
Oh, wow. Somewhere. Great.
If I can find my phone, you get an inside sneak peek. What did I do with my phone?
It's lost in the bag.
We'll find it, because it's all my life's in there.
Oh, yes. At 360 Fashion, we love technology.
Okay, I recently dropped it in the toilet, and it was dead, and I experienced what it's like to have a technological withdrawal, but now it's back.
Oh, my God. Well,
so, if I show you... this is me working on my new tiger. And this is a tiger, so it's exactly the same technique. Mm-hmm. Little facets that are... So from flat to 3D. I don't know if I can...
So now you're doing sculptures?
Well, I'm wanting to translate this into textile. So let's say this technique could come out of a sweater or a jacket. So it doesn't have to be paper, but I work on the paper model first. And then I want to bring it back to textiles.
So what is this tiger made of?
This one is made of paper, but the next one needs to be made of leather.
So
if you have a whole tiger head coming out of a leather jacket, I think that's
super cool.
I
know from the last time you told me this leather, it's quite hard to laser.
Well, at the museum it's hard, but there's lasers that are more... Yeah, you can laser metal, so anything's possible.
Okay, wow.
It just smells really bad.
But how did you make that tiger? Also with laser or something else?
Yeah, this one is hand-cut, but you make it in 3D software, and then there's another software that unfolds it into little facets with numbers on them, and you can glue them together.
Okay, well, wasn't that the 3D printer thing?
No. This is really flat, so it's like printed on normal sheets of paper.
Okay, then you just fold it like a puzzle.
Exactly.
Okay.
It's a puzzle with numbers on them.
But how is your flat jewelry going? Did you
No. The plan is to launch it for sale all over the world.
Oh,
in September.
Super cool. So. I want to know all about it.
Okay, well,
I'm your biggest fan.
Okay, well, then it's...
I still have the rings.
Yeah. No, I found the proper fabric. I got some fabric custom made, and the production is on the way, so it should happen soon.
Okay. And last time I've seen the pearl necklaces, I believe, and the diamond rings, which were embroidered. And what kind of things do you do now?
I'm working on a new collection of bracelets and more kind of like all over pieces, so not just a necklace, but like a whole
bigger
plastron.
Okay, well, it's exciting. we'll keep us updated on everything.
Yes, I'll send
Thank
you
very
updates
much.
On what I'm doing.
Cool. Bye.